I'm reading today from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 10, verses 35 and following. James and John came to Jesus and said, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask." "What do you want me to do for you?" Jesus asked. They replied, "Let us sit, one at your right hand and the other at your left, in your glory." "You don't know what you're asking," Jesus said. "Can you drink the cup I drink, or be baptized with the baptism I am baptized with?" "We can," they answered. Jesus said to them, "You will indeed drink the cup that I drink and be baptized with the baptism I am baptized with. But to sit at my right or left is not for me to grant. These places belong to those for whom they have been prepared." When the other 10 disciples heard about this, they became indignant with James and John. So Jesus called them all together and said, "You know that those who are regarded as rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and their high officials exercise authority over them. Not so with you. Instead, whoever wants to become great among you must be your servant. And whoever wants to be first must be the servant of all. For even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." Classic. Two men jockeying for position, and the other 10 get ticked off because they wanted it but weren't nervy enough to ask. Not much has changed, has it? I can hear my own heart resonate. "Lord, let me sit and make the calls. Oh, Father, deliver me from myself and deliver others from me as well." Not so with you. The Gentiles lord it over them. Not so with you. Oh, may that little phrase stick with us today and every day. Not so with you. We desire a position to sit and rule, when we are called instead to influence, kneel, and serve. We look for a scepter when Christ hands us a towel. We look for authority when Christ hands us opportunity. We desire to boss when Christ calls us to serve. There's a difference, you see. Effective service is about influence and relationships built over time. And every one of us as believers are called to be influencers. Influence is far more powerful than authority. You see, influence focuses on character. Authority focuses on control. Influence needs no authority. Bosses are powerless without it. Bosses tell you where to go. Influences take you there. Bosses measure success in outcomes. Influencers measure success in character transformation. Bosses focus on a task. Influencers focus on the heart. Bosses produce, influencers reproduce themselves in the lives of those they influence. Bosses are always in a hurry. Influencers are always focused, but never frantic. Not so with you. Jesus had a clear plan and purpose for his followers. He still does. But the primary concern of our Savior is the transformation in the hearts and lives of his followers. If my influence is Christ-like, then Christ-like results will come. It's not only what we do, but how we do it that matters. The true test of influence is seen in the lives of those who follow those who've been influenced. It takes two generations to measure a leader's influence. If we are influencing others every day, Well, the fact is, we are influencing others every day, either for good or ill. So let's influence in a not-so-with-you model, the Jesus model, that puts others first and seeks to serve. Lord, give us your heart, the heart of a servant that seeks your glory, that displays your truth in a humble heart. We ask in your name. Amen.